Hello and welcome to the history of Stargate SG-1. Today's episode we're going to be covering Martin Lloyd. And here we go. Martin Lloyd is a human from another planet who, along with a group of others, deserted from their military, which was fighting a losing war with the Goa'uld. After Martin learned of the destruction of his people, he chose to remain on Earth, living a relatively normal life. As the war with Martin's people and the Goa'uld was taking a turn for the worse, Lloyd and the rest of his ship's crew was sent away to find allies. When they discovered the Tok'ra, they instead chose to desert and hide on the remote planet. They hid their ship somewhere in the solar system and crashed in Montana using an escape pod. However, over time, Martin became convinced that deserting their people was wrong and tried to convince the others to return. His comrades weren't swayed, and realizing Martin was now a liability, drugged him with pharmaceuticals that made him lose most of his memories. They kept his home under watch and ensured he continued to remain oblivious to his alien origins. One of his former shipmates posed as a psychiatrist, Dr. Peter Tanner, and continued to prescribe him with various drugs laced with the memory loss chemical. In the year 2000, because of the memory loss, Lloyd began suffering from severe paranoia and became a conspiracy theorist. He felt as if he was being watched by the government and even kept a detailed diary of his daily activities. Eventually, Lloyd became aware of the Stargate program and demanded a meeting with Colonel Jack O'Neill. As more and more of Martin's memories began to resurface, SG-1 searched for his home in Montana, discovering the drugs Lloyd was taking, eventually becoming aware that he was an alien. He convinced O'Neill to follow him back to the location of his buried escape pod. After they found the craft and Lloyd's memory completely returned, he provided Stargate Command with the Stargate address to his homeworld. However, SG-1 found it annihilated by the Goa'uld, with no hint of survivors. 2001. Martin returned to Earth, where he tried to live a normal life. The United States Air Force provided him with a job, and it was expected that he would never be heard from again. However, Martin eventually became disgruntled with his life and started taking the drugs again, voluntarily, to forget what he had seen. He hoped that if he had taken the drugs long enough, the memory loss would become permanent. But as his latent memories began to resurface again, Martin created a campy science fiction television show based on the real Stargate program and SG-1. The show was picked up with the name Wormhole Extreme, and Martin was made a creative consultant. Although the SGC were initially concerned about the possible security leak, once they confirmed that Martin legitimately didn't do anything on purpose, they decided to allow the show to continue, reasoning that its existence would allow for plausible deniability if anyone found out about the real Stargate program, as they could then claim it had simply been watching too much TV. However, in the meantime, Martin's ship was returning to Earth because of a timed homing mechanism. As the approaching ship was discovered by Stargate Command, SG-1 tracked down Martin once again. When he did remember, Martin told the team that the ship approaching Earth was coming to pick up his former comrades. The aliens left Earth, but Martin stayed behind to continue working with the producers of Wormhole Extreme. 2006. Although Wormhole Extreme only aired 3 episodes, DVD sales were successful, and the studio approached Martin about developing a television movie based on the series. Martin approached Stargate Command to review the movie script, and the Pentagon agreed for plausible deniability reasons. Martin was excited to conduct a spin session with SG-1, although the team itself was less amused. However, the eventual movie was canceled, although the series was renewed instead. The renewed Wormhole Extreme went on for 10 years with Martin Lloyd as producer. Thanks for watching the history of Stargate. Have a great day. Bye-bye.